This is Shane with thatsitguys.com. Today I'll be doing a video repair guide for the Everex XT5300T, and this will also work on other models such as the XT5000T and several others that we'll have listed below.
All right, we've got the Everex XT5300T with the classic video card issue, and we're going to do a repair guide on here. I've already removed the CPU and removed the heatsink as well, which if you have an Everex XT5000T, you'll notice it's a solid heatsink instead of two separate units, which we'll show later. And it's actually a bulkier heatsink. The actual heat pipe itself is thicker, a little bit wider, and the actual grill is a little bit taller, it's a little bit more deep, and it's wider. So you actually have to modify this in order to fit it into the original series laptop if you chose to do so. Just the basic requirements. You need a decent heat gun. I just grabbed the cheapest one they had, which was a Wagner heat gun, HT1000. Only has two temperature settings, but that's fine. We'll see how it works out. And then we'll need just a little bit of solder. Any type will do. And just aluminum foil to wrap the rest of the laptop. All right, we have the laptop fully wrapped. And what we're actually going to be doing is heating up both the North Bridge and the GPU. All right, we're just going to run this in a circular pattern, just like this, making an 8. Over the chips, and we're not really going to go for the memory chips because they usually don't go bad, but if that is an issue, we can go back over. Problem with that is I have to completely disassemble the laptop to get to them because the back chips are right back here. So let's get going on this. Definitely feel it heating up though. I can actually feel the pressure coming up off this. Actually noticing the solder start to melt here, so I know I'm getting pretty close. This is actually this is leaded solder, and this board uses lead-free solder, so it is going to need to be a little bit hotter, but I am noticing the heat is getting up there, so I'm going to be stopping this in just a moment, just kind of getting the last few phases done. I think we should be good. We'll just do a cool down period of approximately 15 to 30 minutes, depending upon the temperature in the area. All right, now the unit should be cooled down enough. Now, I haven't actually bolted anything in. I just want to make sure before I reassemble everything, is this going to work? So we will see, find out. All right, just have the laptop turned on its side and we'll check out how this works. Got it running on battery, so we'll see if the screen comes on. Oh, dear God, we've done it. That's crazy. So, we have a working laptop, which would not boot or anything before, but now will. Awesome. And the laptop is working perfectly fine after the repair and hasn't had any issues since. All of the information is available on our website, where you'll find the latest tech news and reviews at thatsitguys.com. Thanks for watching.